All right, so we made a little bit of a mistake when we launched our latest YouTube video, which depending on when you are watching this video, it maybe is a long time ago, but I just felt like it was the right thing to do to release the stuff that was not completed. So what we did was we record at least two videos at a time. And this video, just so you know, and you can skip over the rest of this and jump directly into the meat, this video is gonna be a breakdown of ads. It's actually gonna get into Ads Manager, and it's actually gonna break down numbers. I'm gonna tell you the full format to actually how to run ads for a clothing brand right now. So if you got to that part, kind of skip ahead and you can watch the actual part of that video. However, if you wanna know the reason why this video is being recorded, we record two videos at one time, so for 2 weeks. And then what happened was, is we put the end of the video, we had stopped recording because we ran out of basically time, and stopped the recording and then put the end of next week's video at the end of this week's video. And so if you got to the last like 5 minutes of that 18, 20 minute video, it probably looked a little bit wonkier than normal. So anyway, that's why we did that. I hope this is helpful for you. Go check out the video. It is an actual breakdown of the ads. It is inside of Ads Manager and the complete setup. So enjoy the video. Hopefully Franklin cut some of this stuff out because I've been talking for a minute, but peace. All right, so I'm gonna draw this out on the whiteboard on exactly how I would set up the campaign, the way that the segments would work, and then I'm gonna actually show you inside of Ads Manager here as well. Okay, so let's look at this in two different ways, right? So we have a scale campaign and a testing campaign. The testing campaign, when you're first starting out, you can go broad. You can also put in an existing audience to try to tell Meta to go after an audience or people like your audience. Basically, we're just testing the creative here. Okay, so this is likely where we're gonna spend a decent amount of money. A lot of people will start here. Again, it's broad. You could potentially add interest. We've seen that work well too. Please do not go, like for example, and choose Nike or the brands that have like 400 like million followers or engagers like worldwide. That's way too big. But if you do need some interest and you're just starting an account, I'm not completely opposed to that in that stage. The ad sets need to go based off of ad concepts. So is this like a headline graphic? So it has an actual call out and just basically says the best jeans ever and there's just text on there. Is this an ad set where it's like an us versus them? Is it an ad set where this is just full of reviews? So you're just testing, which again, reviews would be more of like a middle of the funnel, if you will, or going after people who are already warm. I was gonna even write it down here of retargeting. I'm just gonna leave it off of here for right now till I get some definitive data before I even share with you guys. But this is where most people are gonna lie. That's why most of the time it is gonna be broad. You're testing creatives and then you wanna actually scale up. So I'm gonna leave this as a broad campaign. I have ad sets that are literally probably just one ad set, honestly, of just winning campaigns. I would probably set them apart. The reason I put two here is like one would be images, one would be videos. You can test either one of them, but a broad campaign, image or video, and then only winning ads. If you don't have multiple winning ads, I probably wouldn't even move to this scaling campaign. You need to get to a point where this is getting a good amount cost per purchase for you and you wanna spend more money. Let's say, for example, it is costing you well below your cost per acquisition goal. Let's say it's $30 and you're at 22 and you've got five ads here. I would move them over and then dump in a new ad set so that you can start testing the new set of creative. Now these winning ones get more budget and they can scale up. If you're not to that point, don't worry about it. One campaign, one ad set will all work fine. Again, I'll kind of show that to you right now because it is important. There are many, many ad accounts where, for example, this one right now, I have it set up and there's, what is this, 11 days into it. Let's just look at the last 30 days. 500 purchases, $10 cost per purchase, like one campaign, one ad set, multiple ads. So like, is working regardless. You can just go this route. I'm talking about when you really want to scale up, and that's spending $300, $400, $500 a day. This is scaling after the fact, which I may do a little bit more of an in-depth type of training when we have more data on the retargeting side. Because previously, if you went broad, it basically was a catch-all and got everything. However, things are changing. Try to give you updated content as we see them as well, which is why I wanted to put out this video in the first place. Okay, so this ad account is spending over $3,000 per day. Whether you're starting out at $30 a day or $3,000 a day, the same campaign setup can be done here regardless. So you're going to hit create. You're going to go down to sales. You always want to go for sales. Do not go for traffic. Do not listen to meta and go for add to carts. Do not do anything except for to go for sales. If you are a clothing brand trying to make sales online, that is it. You're also going to choose the campaign budget, okay? This means that the budget is going to be distributed from here across where it believes each ad set and ads are going to make the most money. So the budget could go at, let's say, $300 a day here, and it could spend $200 here and could spend $100 here and then distribute it between the actual ads, okay? So all the budget is distributed here versus at the ad set level where you determine and say, this is $50 for this one and this one is $250. You don't determine it. Let Meta choose its options. So that's campaign budget. We do suggest minimum starting out at $30 a day and then testing 2 to 3 ads down here at this level. If you have more ads in here at $30 a day, it's not going to spend correctly or never give it a chance to it. If you have hundreds of dollars and you only put 2 pieces of creative, you're going to run into creative fatigue very quickly as well. So you got to kind of find that middle ground for you. $100, you could put in 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 ads potentially, but just look at the ads as they start to scale, what's happening there. So the conversion location, you can now do messaging apps, you can do whatever, but we choose website. There is a website and website and shop has now changed, and it used to be like 2 options. Now it's just literally the website. Maximum number of conversions, the data set is what it's called now. Make sure that you actually have your pixel. Make sure the conversions API is turned on. Make sure you're going for purchases, and we leave it broad. If you want to further limit the ads, which we do, this will allow you to go back to what you really want to hone in on, which I talked about earlier, so you actually know the age and the gender that you're going after, so that when you look at the segments, you're not spending a bunch of money on 30-year-olds when you should be going after 65-year-olds. Right, placements, leave those where they're at. Go ahead and hit next. All right, and then the ad preview, you'll have that. And now we're just going to create single ads. Make sure that it goes to either a collection page or to a product page, depending on what you're actually advertising. If it's a photo or video showcasing multiple things, make sure it goes to the collection. I prefer that route more than a single product. If you have only a single product, then a DPA or a catalog may work best for you. But on this stage, most of the time, do not send them to the homepage here, especially for that. It's just an extra click for them. You should be able to give them enough information that it makes a lot of sense for them to go to the collection page or to the product page. All right, so put in the URL and then you will put in your actual ads. Now in this video, I'm not really too worried about the creative piece. There is a whole nother video that I created on the creative and how to use it and the methodology for all of those things. Okay, so that is the full setup here. Obviously you put in your creative, obviously you would put in the right columns, which I care more about purchases. I care about more frequency. I care about the cost per 1,000 impressions, the unique click-through rate, and then all of your costs for like add to cart, etc. But I'm really interested in cost per purchase and the return on ad spend. Those are kind of the main things. You can get lost in all of the numbers, but really, if you just focus on those ones, you will be fine. And look, if you're truly looking to scale your clothing brand, then you're going to need way more than meta ads. This is just the basic. You need a strong foundation to scale your clothing brand. If you want that, go watch this video right here next. Thank you all so much for watching. I truly do appreciate it. And P.S., don't forget to subscribe.